As absolutely ridiculous as I probably look when I'm playing PlayStation VR, that hasn't stopped me from having so much fun with that stupid headset. From big budget titles to some hidden gems on the PlayStation Network, I have had some experiences that have made me question my sanity. I have explored some worlds that felt so real I almost thought I was there, and I have played some action games that have made me feel like Liam Neeson in Taken or Keanu Reeves in John Wick. So today, I would love to talk about 10 of my favorite games for the PlayStation VR. Games that if you haven't played and you have a PSVR, you're missing out, or maybe these are reasons to go ahead and pick a PlayStation VR up for the first time. So I don't know about you, but I am ready to start this video. So if you're watching this on PlayStation 4 and you have VR, throw that headset on, watch this video in VR, remember to hit like, subscribe if you haven't already, and let's get started. Okay, look, all those physical games aside, I need to start with the PlayStation Network game because this is my favorite VR game I've played. I'm starting with my favorite because I can't wait to talk about it, and that game is Super Hot. And as soon as I saw it, I knew I had to try it, and I'm so glad I did. This is one of them action games I was talking about that makes you feel like a badass, and it puts you in a series of scenarios. The game will load up and you'll see the enemies in front of you, and you'll have to figure out how you're gonna take them down. What is the coolest way to take them down, but mostly just how are we gonna survive this scenario? The big draw to this game is the game only moves when you move. If you stand still, the game will stand still. And that really leads to you being able to take control of situations and do whatever kind of badass things you want. Also, another great thing about that mechanic is the first few times you play a scenario, you can play it as slow as you want. And then when you start to get a feel for how these scenarios are gonna go down, you can try and do it as fast as you can. And that's when you start to feel really cool. From punching a guy in the throat and catching his gun as he falls, spinning around and shooting someone else in the face and catching his knife and throwing that knife at someone else, having to duck to avoid a shotgun spray, and then coming up John Wick style and blasting enemies with two pistols, the fun never stops in this game. You can be as creative as you want in your tactics, in your kills, the weapons you want to use, the things you want to throw, from emptying an entire magazine in a gun and then throwing that gun to shatter that last enemy. This is one of them games that's fun to watch, fun to play, fun to everything. They did a great job with Super Hot VR. Now, this is another one of my favorites for the system, and that is Job Simulator. Fortunately, they have a sequel coming out called Vacation Simulator. I am so excited for that. This is the first game that I played on my VR that made me realize there was potential here. There was something here in the VR universe that I was really going to love. Job Simulator is exactly that. And I think one of the best things about this game is no matter who I've explained this game to, it always seems boring on paper. And then as soon as you play it, you get it. And it's an incredible amount of fun. There are 5 different jobs you can simulate in this game, from a chef to a mechanic to an office worker. Office worker, by far the best one. You would think just having an office cubicle to stand in would be as boring as it probably is in real life. No offense to anyone that works in an office cubicle, definitely not for me. But as soon as you stand there and you realize you can do anything you want, from throwing donuts into other cubicles, to pouring yourself a coffee and trying to make sure you actually get the creamer into the cup, from doing the challenges that you're given from the boss, to firing and hiring people, it seems so mundane. But when you're playing it, it is just so incredibly exhilarating. Beside from the office worker, being a mechanic is my other favorite. Cars will come in and you gotta figure out what's wrong with them and replace certain parts on the car. It sounds mediocre, doesn't it? But trust me, when you start playing it, when you start pulling off tires and trying to free throw them into the bin to make the confetti pop out, or when you realize there's a radio behind you with a bunch of different stations and you can crank up the volume while you get to work on these cars, there are so many little things in this game that will give you that moment of, oh, that's pretty cool. So Job Simulator, it's pretty cheap, and it's a testament to exactly what a good VR game can be. The Invisible Hours was a game that I was skeptical about buying, but Kim actually got it for me for Christmas because she thought I would like it because it's similar to a Telltale style of game that I love so much. It's a story-driven murder mystery game where you have to try and figure out who the killer is. As soon as I started playing it, I wasn't too sure if I was sold on it, but suddenly when the mechanics started falling into place, I started to actually get pretty engrossed in the game and then ended up finishing it in one sitting. In this game, you can pause, rewind, and fast forward time. Initially, I was confused as to why this game even had that mechanic, but quickly as I was playing, it became very clear. Without trying to give too much away, there is an entire movie story that plays within this mansion. There are so many different rooms and there's always different characters in each room doing different things. And you don't just follow a linear story, you are literally in this mansion and you can free roam around and look at anything you want at any given time. So initially when I walked in and there was this dead body, I decided to follow the private detective and see his path of the story. And I sort of started to develop my theories, my ideas as to who the killer actually might be. But then as soon as I rewound time and followed someone else through their journey, more things started to open up and I started to realize there was way more to this story, way more story arcs to all these different characters than I initially realized. All the characters in this story have their own personal development, their own growth, and their own story arcs. And it was definitely a really interesting take on a story-driven game. I found myself wanting to follow every single character through every single second of the game, rewinding and fast-forwarding, making sure I hadn't missed anything in any of the rooms. There are some hidden secrets, there's even a secret ending if you do a certain thing the right way. Just for its unique I would recommend trying this game. I personally had a lot of fun with it, but it definitely has to be something that you're interested in. If you like Telltale games, if you like story-driven games or puzzle games or murder mysteries, this is gonna be up your alley. If you're looking for something a little bit more action-y, this might not be for you. Rush of Blood was my first PlayStation VR experience, and I really liked it. This is brought to us from the same people that made Until Dawn, so as you can expect, it's very freaky. It's an on-rail shooter game which gets really intense when things start running at you, when these clowns start bombarding you in the darkness, and you're just sat there and you can't move or get away from them, you just gotta try and shoot them. You're on a roller coaster, and it really makes you feel like you are sat on a freaky-ass roller coaster. Dark and weave from oncoming objects, from having to shoot at clowns and targets as you go past, and just trying to survive this nightmare-fueled carnival ride. Aiming and shooting in this game is really responsive, it feels really nice. The only thing I don't really like is the dips in the roller coaster make me feel a little sick, but they never last long enough for me to actually get motion sick from them. And that adds to the game, it adds to that feeling that you're on a roller coaster and it is trying to freak you out, which it's definitely doing. I get motion sick in these games really easily. But if you want a point and shoot on rail shooter and you want to be on edge and get a little bit scared, this is the game for you. But if you want to get really scared, let's talk about Resident Evil 7 real quick. I say let's talk about it real quick because I only played it in VR real quick. Again, I get motion sick really easily and free walking around, free roaming games like this where you use both sticks to move definitely turns my stomach really quick. I have to say though that as far as those kind of games go, this one was really great at not making me feel sick. You move so slow in this game at such a steady pace. It doesn't really throw me off too much. Now here's what I'll say about this game being in VR. I love that they took this entire game and they made it playable in VR. No other big budget game that I know has actually done that with their game, taken the exact game and made it VR. I like that a lot, and being in that world makes it so much scarier. Just the initial walking through a forest and getting used to the controls and starting to get into the world, and then you find that first shack and you look inside, you literally look inside and feel like you're there, and it's just black. It is just darkness inside and no lights, and that alone had me terrified. I am a baby. I don't like horror games. I've never liked horror games. I can't handle them. I get way too scared, and even just trying to work up the nerve to walk in that room had me on edge. I did finally do it. I explored that shack for a little bit, but it was just sensory overload for me. I used the excuse of feeling a little sick to stop playing and just kept playing the game regularly, not in VR. But I really liked the concept. And I could tell by playing it that if you're into horror games, if you love horror games and you want a horror game in VR, just stay away if you're a baby like me. That's all I'm saying. I'm gonna touch on Doom VR really quick because I love it, but I have done a video pretty much about just this game already on my channel, and you can go check that out in the description below if you want a way more in-depth look into how I feel about this game. But the best way I can explain it real quick is if you loved Doom and you wanna play that in VR, this is an amazing experience. It literally puts you right in the middle of that game. It builds its own story. It's a completely separate campaign, but it feels the same just in VR. If you can imagine the Doom that you played, but actually being there, that's exactly what this game does. One thing I'll say about the game really quick is a few of my friends went out and picked it up after I reviewed it, and they couldn't get their heads around the controls. So I will say that you have to stick with the controls for a little bit to get a hang of it, but once you do, I love the way I zipped around that game, destroying things like it was my job. I debated putting Batman Arkham VR on this list because it is so short. I think it took me about an hour to finish. It really isn't a long game. It's pretty much a tech demo. But for what it is, actually pretty amazing. It makes you feel like you live a day in the life of Batman. From descending from his mansion and putting on your bat suit, to descending even further and being in the damn Batcave, which feels pretty cool. To going to crime scenes and using all of his different gadgets like the grappling hook and a forensic scanner and a Batarang. You meet the Penguin and you meet the Joker, and that's the point where this whole thing is worth playing. For the first half of the game, I was really skeptical on it and I wasn't gonna put it on the list, but as soon as I met the Joker and realized, A, it's Mark Hamill's Joker, any game that has Mark Hamill playing the Joker is worth playing, but as soon as you get down in the sewers and you are with Robin and you're working with him trying to get out of that cage, the game got really intense and really great. I loved that part of the game, but the next part of the game was one of the best VR experiences I've had, and it was only about 5 minutes long, not even that, but you're in this cell, and I don't want to give it away, but this is the selling point of the game for me. You're in this cell as Batman, and Batman is losing his mind, and you feel like you are actually losing your mind. It was almost too freaky for me, and I wanted to take the headset off, but I persevered, and I'm so glad I did. Every time you turn around, things change, you get jump scares, something will mix up, there's so many sounds in your head, the walls start moving in closer, and there was something about it that honestly made me question my sanity in that moment. Made me question, wait, did I actually see that before, or am I forgetting what I saw in the game? It was really trippy, and I took the headset off after I'd finished that part, and I just kind of went, wow, that was actually pretty legit. So if you can pick this game up pretty cheap, there are a few really cool moments leading up to that, but that even though it's only about 5 minutes long, it was really, really fun. So Kim's actually really been enjoying playing my PlayStation VR as well. She really likes Job Simulator. She heard about a game called Shooty Fruity and wanted me to pick it up, and I'm glad I did. It's a lot like Job Simulator in a way, where you work as a checkout person where you need to scan groceries, but while you're scanning the groceries, a bunch of fruit, alive living fruit, start trying to bombard you, and you need to pull guns, grenades, and shotguns out from a conveyor belt to shoot them while still trying to concentrate on doing your job. So it's a mix of trying to really quickly scan groceries and pulling down shotguns and dual wielding and trying to kill things, or sometimes trying to shoot things while trying to scan groceries. It gets really hectic, especially in later levels when they add more and more challenges, more and more types of fruit, and more weird things you're supposed to be doing down here. But all up, it controls really well. It even has a shooting range where you can test out all of these weapons as much as you want. You can get grenades and bite the pin out and throw them. It's a weird and wacky game, but the variety of weapons and the variety of fruit, and again the variety of things you're supposed to be doing all mixed up into one, definitely led to an intense experience. It sort of takes that Job Simulator humor as well and implements it in this game. It's sort of a mesh of a shooting game and something like Job Simulator. So definitely one I recommend. Sports Bar 2.0 is by far the best online VR game I've played, the best one I've seen. It's exactly how it sounds. It's a huge bar with pool tables, darts, skee ball, chess, air hockey, where you can create a room or you can go online and have friends join your room. You can play a game of pool with people. You can play darts with people. We had myself, 8-Bit Eric, Billy from Game Chasers, and Joe from GameSack in a bar just messing around and having fun. And it's not only the games they've given you to play, it's also things like taking darts and throwing them at the balloon animals, or it's like going around and messing with the NPC characters, putting a bucket on the bartender's head, standing at the bar and pretending to have drinks. I know it sounds stupid, but so many of these VR games are incredibly fun when you're actually there. Mundane things like lining up glass bottles on the bar and taking out a toy gun and starting to shoot them down. It just feels like, imagine if you went to an actual bar with your friends and you were allowed to run amok and do whatever you wanted. There's a lot of other secrets and fun things to explore in this game that I haven't talked about, and I also like that they seem to be updating this game, adding new things, adding new rooms, adding new features. So it's definitely worth the $20 I think I paid to pick it up. And lastly, we have a game called Blood and Truth, which is actually coming soon. But for those of you that played the VR PlayStation Worlds, there's a ton of different kind of tech demo games on this disc. And the only one I really enjoyed was the London Heist. It puts you in a London gangster mobster type world where you had a bunch of people talking at you and interrogating you. You had the opportunity to pick up some guns and go crazy. There was a pretty cool highway chase. You're shooting at a bunch of moving cars and bikes and your ammo would run out and you'd empty the clip and you'd slam in another one. There was a lot of fun to be had in that demo. I really enjoyed it and the voice acting was pretty good, but it was short and again, it was just a demo. Well, the creators of that game actually took that world and expanded on it, and they made a full-fledged VR game out of it, a full experience, but they have upgraded so many things. From everything they've been talking about, what they wanted to do was actually take the big blockbuster action movies like the ones I mentioned earlier, Liam Neeson, John Wick, Taken, blah, 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 and make you feel like you are playing that. And while I loved Superhot is so much fun and I still recommend it, that's very much a static, you stand in one place and you try and figure out ways, cool ways to kill these red glass enemies. But this, you can actually move around, walk around, hide behind cover, and it's in realistic environments with actual enemies. The weapons are more realistic. You actually empty clips and put in new clips. And it's not just scenarios put here, put here, put here. It's an actual full-fledged story. This looks like the closest thing and the best thing I've seen to actually putting you in an action movie, a consistent, continuing action movie. So if you haven't played London Heist, pick that up, try it out. But imagine being able to actually get up, move around, have the freedom of being able to do whatever you want and just be a badass action hero, which I'm definitely looking forward to from Blood and Truth. Well guys, I gotta be honest, I'd never reviewed VR games before. That was my first time and it's really different trying to explain VR experiences. It's a lot harder than I thought it was gonna be. I hope I did a good job in this video. Again, I've never reviewed VR games before, and it took me twice as long to record this as it does my usual videos because I almost had no idea what I was saying half the time. I hope it came across well. I hope you hit that like button. I hope you subscribed. It doesn't really work when I'm wearing a beanie. I hope you subscribed. Leave a comment down below with what VR games you would recommend picking up and playing. And remember to actually get outside in the real world and go and do things. Don't just sit at home in virtual worlds, as fun as they might be. Actually go out and explore the world. I appreciate you guys watching my videos. You know I love you all, and I'll see you in the next one. I need to order some kind of food though. I'm hungry.